Hello, folks, and welcome back to Stellaris. As always, of course, I am Falcon, your host. I have once again kind of shifted around my controlled planets slightly so that I could take control of this planet, the system in general, that has just been suffering very badly under the governorship, because the governor just is terrible at his job. This planet, you know, only had two slots open all this time. Now it has a bunch more because I took over the planet, so I was able to remove all of the things that have been blocking their construction and growth for so long, which has just been really bad for us. Like, I mean, it has really negatively affected the planet and its potential growth for a long time. That is no longer going to be the case, however. We are now in the process of building up the planet, working on it. Broadleaf also has suffered greatly because, I mean, they haven't even upgraded the damn ship shelter to something that's actually, you know, worthwhile and meaningful. So I have begun that, and as soon as that finishes, I'll upgrade all the stuff on the planet. And then I will tear out all of these blockers and build, a variety of things, but it's going to have to mostly be energy credits, because again, our energy credits have dropped drastically. Now, part of that is the fact that I am controlling planets that I shouldn't be controlling. Controlling more than I should be controlling, I should say. Which is not helping the situation any. Port Snedden here is now in the process of building a crapload of power plants, which is what my plan for the system had been all along. It is now finally in the process of actually accomplishing that. It is unfortunately going to take some time to get there, but it's working on it. It'll get there eventually. It's going to take a while, but it'll get there eventually. So, with that in the process of being done, I did actually rip out the science lab that they had here because I wanted to be able to get the alien pets resource. That is one of the few planets that I have that has that resource, and apparently there's no building that you can build on top of it that will actually give you that resource. You have to not have a building there to be able to gain it if it's a planet that you actually are living on. Which sucks, but... oh well. Sucks, but not a whole hell of a lot I can do about it. We did build our outpost out here, so we do have the Ingos Vapor coming in, which I am taking advantage of at Dawnlight, the shipyard that we've been using for so long. We're building the refinery, which will give energy weapon increased damage. We did research battleships. I don't remember if that happened off camera, in the brief time that I was messing around off camera, or if it happened in the last episode, I don't remember. I did design these ships off camera, however, this Demolisher was the basic ship, upgraded to where it should be. Very tanky, very good shields, very good armor, a variety of weaponry, both space torpedoes and lasers to give it both armor and shield penetration, and then some point defense and an autocannon just to round out its thing. The battleships also have these. One of these is the subspace snare, so it's the same as our one ship. Not a ship, our one station that we can build, rather, which gives it, you know, prevents the enemies from being able to get away from it, which is really cool. That's that one. The Concordia, so named for anyone who has played Wing Commander, because it is a fighter ship. It's a carrier. So I'm sure you can guess why it was named Concordia, if you have any idea about what I'm talking about. Is armed with all space torpedoes and a crapload of point defense to basically protect the fleet from any missiles, torpedoes, whatever, and just, you know, provided a good amount of firepower to go with those. And then this one has a nanobot cloud, which will heal ships around it. So it provides, you know, it's a support ship. It's got carriers, it's got defense, and it's got a healing capability. And then we have the World Eater, which is all energy weapons, mostly to take advantage of the fact that we have that energy bonus damage thing. And also gives us armor penetration, and then it has the final one of these upgrades, which is a shield weakening effect on enemy ships. It's also the only one. Oh no, both of these are actually equipped with the defensive thing. This actually should probably be the offensive one now that I think about it. Because that will, not only will that give you more damage, you are more of an offensive ship. The Concordia is a defensive ship, so it doesn't need it as much. So we got, those are the three battleships that we have. And I have the Alpha Centauri shipyard building a couple of demolishers and a couple Concordias, because they do not require the one upgrade as much. The demolishers do have energy weapons, but they're not focused on those. Whereas the Dawnlight shipyard is building the refinery, and then it's going to build a few world eaters once that's complete. So I think we are pretty much where we need to be for the time being. So it is time. Let's actually save again real quick, because it has been a short period of time since I Well, it's actually been a couple years, which I did not realize it was so long, but it's been a little bit of time since I saved last at the end of last episode. But we're gonna go to war with these guys. Oh, I can give things to my allies. That's cool. Anyway, you're going to give me, basically going to give me all of your planets, really. Let's be real here. I just want all of your planets. So that's Bosnak, Colfax, Beta, because that'll give us the edge. Ooh, they have expanded. They had not expanded last time I saw. That's actually a potential problem now, because I don't know that we have the distance to be able to jump across here. I guess we'll find out. Hishma? Almost at max. Ukulon. I didn't know you could go over 100 war score. You didn't used to be able to, but apparently you can now. Well, we're just going to completely wipe these guys out, so I'm not really, to be perfectly honest, I really don't give a shit. We're just going to basically come in here and wipe the floor with these guys, so let's just go ahead and do that, shall we? Pops on the planet, capital of an empire. Galactic ambitions and manifest destiny, I guess. Reduce the what it costs. So because of that, we're able to do this a little more effectively. Interesting. We could actually give one of these planets to our allies. Do I particularly want to do that? Not really. No particular need to. I'm not opposed to doing it by any stretch of the imagination. I just don't need to do it. Oh, yeah, it is too high, so we can't take everything. Okay, we'll give him back. I'll give you back, Akulam, let's say. Give you back Akulam. Give you back the other system in Akalam. Give you back the nuke. And give you back Ukulon. So you'll have those three systems, basically. Alright, we can do that. And now the time has come for you to die.
Hostile fleet engaged.
If that's the best that your fleet can manage, you're already dead. Let me make that very clear. If that is all you've got, you are already dead. And it very well might be, because you really don't have the capability to do much to me at this point. You just don't anymore. It's not that you...
Situation log updated. Hostile fleet engaged.
It's not that you, you know, don't
Hostile
have
fleet engaged.
Any combat capability or anything. It's the simple fact that you have zero chance in hell of being able to do anything to me. You're just straight up gonna die, and that's all there is to it. You just can't win. Which you'll quickly learn. Make no mistake, you will very, very quickly learn that. We also can start building ourselves a xenomorph fort army. Just the hordes. Xenomorph hordes. That's five of them. Six, seven, eight, nine, and ten. These guys take a long time to build. I should have built them up beforehand, but oh well. We won't get to probably get to use these guys at all this war, but that's fine. We don't really need them. It's not really what they're here for, so it's all good. Alright, where are you guys even at? You're up there. Let's go ahead and move yourselves to Opera Max for the moment. Just want to basically get you in position to be able to do things what we're prepared to do things. We don't need you to do anything yet, but we will soon. I completed the construction of a mining station. And then we can actually kick out these guys. Why are you building a defense army? Who the hell told you to build defense armies? No, but really, who told you to build defense armies? Same with you, you're building defense armies. Why are you doing that? Are all the planets doing that? No. Are you building it because enemy ships have been seen in your territory? I mean, that would make sense, right? If enemy ships have been seen around, that would make some degree of sense, at least. Fleet 11. That would make some sense, I suppose.
Fleet engaged.
Where are you going there, buddy? Oh, hold on. Where?
Hostile fleet engaged. Hostile fleet engaged. Situation log updated.
Guys.
Situation log updated.
You just nuked the hell out of their stuff on the system there for no goddamn reason, really. Alright. Oh, whatever. You're dead. You're dead. You're dead before you've even realized what's going on. 10 is the one that has the fleet. Go ahead and send you in. You'll easily be able to take the system. So that should not be a problem whatsoever. You guys are talking to us now. Don't know what that's gonna mean, but... Don't know what precisely that'll end up meaning, but you're talking to me, so... You know. Could be good. Could be really bad.
Construction we'll find complete. Out. Construction
they are
complete.
Continuing to grow over here. That's not good. Not good at all. Okay, Dawnlight finished its thing, so now you can build a couple of World Eaters. And Broadleaf finished its construction. What did I even have you building? Oh, I had you building. Okay, that's what I had you building. That's fine. Do we even build, like, ship that should be built on the right places? For the most part, yes. Not all the time, though. Like, right there, it was, should not have been built there, but... Whatever. Let's replace that with a science lab. We'll replace this one with a mine. Right? Yeah. Replace that with a mine. Upgrade the farms. Go through and rip out clear out the other couple places that have food because we'll probably need them, then clear out the places with energy because that's the other thing that we really want. Oh, actually, hold on, don't do any of that, don't do any of that clearing shit out actually, because I'm wasting money doing it. We can do it for like half that price because we have that one guy. I just have to assign the one guy over here. So never mind, just do what I already told you to do, and then once you finish all that, then I'll come back and we'll take a look at it again. So once you finish that, it has built this place up now to where it needs to be. Did you have a spaceport? And if you did I build the thing that I should have built here? No, I did not. Okay, so you need the hydroponic farm, which I should have built a long fucking time ago. And you probably need the same thing. Hydroponic farm, we also need to upgrade the spaceport at both of these planets so that we can get a second upgrade, which will be the solar panel network. because that negates the shipyards actually do cost resources. I did not realize that. I would have assumed that was kind of the case, but I wasn't sure. Governor something or other has leveled up and gained a bad trait. Task of bringing the local civilization up to the space age. Cool. One of our subjects has entered a war. It's unfortunate for her. Who's this governor person that leveled up? Oh, is it the chick here? That's actually bad. I don't want... Yeah, that's not good. Leader experience gain went down. Actually, that doesn't matter, because you're already at full level, so... That literally does nothing. Literally does nothing. Okay, so now we pulled you over to Broadleaf. Where I can now... Let's go ahead and tell it to upgrade these. Might as well. Isn't that ripping that one out? No, I guess not. Go ahead and upgrade those, and now I tell you to go in. Clear out all the places with food. Cancel that one and clear that one out. Then clear out the places with energy. I'm sure I didn't cancel that one before. And then just proceed to clear out everything else. Because it's like less than half the price that would have been previous to that. To clear those out with her in charge. Which is a much smarter idea than trying to fuck around with it any other way. Because it's just a waste of time trying to do it any other... via any other means. Alright, so you at least have your own system now. Actually, probably don't need this frontier outpost here anymore, because it's not... Well, actually, it is still doing something for me, never mind. Because it's giving me... dominion over a couple of these other spots, which I need to actually maintain, so... Okay, that's fine then. We're good. Alright, so you can land armies. As soon as these guys land... This is gonna go very badly for them. This should be pretty quick.
Incoming transmission.
I highly doubt that this will last very long. You want to give me star charts. I don't actually want that, thanks. I don't Pursuit actually complete. Want that right Enemy now. And that didn't last long. That was a short battle. here we go, we need to remove these. We need the quicksand removal thing because we have that one planet that has that as a tile blocker, which is very detrimental to that system. Okay, fleet is moving.
Hostile fleet engaged.
Surprise, bitches! Oh. Oh. Hold on. Did I send... What happened here? Fine. Never mind. We're good. You're so dead. You're so dead. You don't even realize how dead you are, but you're very, very dead. Very, very dead. What is that? That does not look like a thing that I want to deal with. Oh, it's transport ship. Okay, whatever. No one cares. No one cares then. So what do you have? A couple of... a bunch of corvettes. Which are otherwise known as cannon fodder. A few cruisers. Again, otherwise known as cannon fodder. You're so fucked, dudes. So fucked. Look at that. Your fleet just melts.
Situation
melts and absolutely disintegrates. melts and absolutely disintegrates. Okay, so that right there is the research that we want to hit.
Situation log updated.
Previously unknown species. Whatever, dudes. I don't know where you are, but I have a feeling you're so far away that I could care less. Oh, you are big. Whoever the hell you are. Oh, yeah, never mind. I'd found them before. You're just very large. Much larger than I'm kind of used to. Okay. Alright, so the science ship is moving.
Research complete.
Oh. Ooh, a frontier outpost. I need to go kill that. We seriously wiped them out that fast? Wow. Alright. Transport fleet. Get in here and land your troops.
Construction complete.
I guess you're fine. They don't attack, I guess. They've ended their rivalry. Declared them your rival because you're an idiot. Whatever. Mining station stuff. Actually have things, other things to do up there in that system. Build a research station. Broadleaf. Which one are you? Alright. Now you can build a solar panel. And same with you. There we go. That helps out those two planets and they're growing. Which is what we were there for. It's what we needed. It's why we came up here in the first place. Apparently this unlocked at some point when I wasn't paying a damn bit of attention. Do I even care about any of these? Like, really? Don't really know that I necessarily do. Let's get the Ripper thing, I guess. Look at that, and then... kind of whatever at that point. I probably just destroyed their fleet. That fleet that we just killed is probably their fleet. Probably was their fleet. It's not even that, like, they have other stuff. It probably was literally, like, the extent of their fleet. It was probably all that they had. And since they don't have it now, well...
Evading hostile fleet.
Seriously. Why are you evading? Are you stupid? Stop. You're retarded.
Hostile fleet engaged. Debris analyzed.
Alright, so what do we get? Oh, they had armored torpedoes. And carrier operations. Cool. So you did have some new tech. Nice. I don't think we really got that much out of it, but nice, nevertheless. This Corvette is
Research
so dead.
Complete.
Don't even know how dead you are there, buddy.
Situation log updated.
Instantaneous explosion. What are you doing? Are you stupid? Here, allow me to send my ships in one at a fucking time so you can massacre them piecemeal.
Construction complete. Hostile fleet engaged.
Are you... just... stupid? Or something? I don't get it.
Enemy planet secured.
Like, for real, are you just straight
Situation
up retarded?
Updated. Research complete.
You must be, because... Lord knows you just made a boo-boo. Alright, so whatever. Spaceport's finished. Invasion over. Combat over. Research completed. UV lasers. Oh. X-ray lasers. Nice. So that's the even more upgraded version of what we just did. There's improved power plants. I should probably work on that because I do need... We do kind of need the power plant thing. We're kind of getting our asses kicked when it comes to power plant stuff. And this person is actually going to be able to blow this out of the water really quick, so... You should have zero difficulty in researching this at a remarkable speed. If I go in to research that. You're just gonna blow through that in no time flat. Core sectors! Here we go, this is one thing that I needed right here. That is very important, we need to have that. Is it just in general? Yeah. That's actually pretty useful. But I want this so much. I'm gonna go ahead and get that, because that's actually kind of important. Kind of important and kind of helpful. Okay, you can really kind of not. Oh, really? You actually have a fleet. What is this fleet made of? Where the hell did you even get... What do you have? Alright, I'm not gonna lie. I am impressed that you managed to assemble any fleet whatsoever, let alone one that's actually not absolutely terrible. Oh, they've gone ahead and built wormhole stations so they can warp around in our system, in our territory, too. That's cool. I'm actually, totally down for that.
Hostile fleet engaged.
You'll clean up their little ships that they've got going on. So I'm fine with that.
Situation
really am.
Updated.
I'm not gonna complain about that at all. Totally cool with it. What are you doing?
Debris analyzed.
Okay, so that gave us more Ripper Cannon tech, which is fine. We are actually working on Ripper Cannons, though, so that actually does help us a little bit. Albeit very little, but still. I'll take it. So we have another transport fleet in the works, in the wings, kind of waiting for us to move in when we are ready to do so.
Hostile fleet engaged.
Where? Uh-oh. Vacate.
Fleet.
Get out of there. I'm actually just going to retreat you all the way back. Quit trying to evade, but just go back to Opera Max. You don't even need to be up here anymore. We pretty much have the tech that we wanted out of them, so...
Situation log updated.
Just vacate there, guys. Our allies are holding them off over there. Pretty
hostile
well.
Fleet engaged.
So I'm not at all concerned. I mean, seriously, that Corvette is so dead.
Situation log updated.
To be honest, I'm shocked and amazed he didn't just immediately explode. Like, the instant that we arrived in the area, I'm surprised he didn't just immediately explode. Like, instantaneously. Quite surprised that he didn't just instantaneously detonate. Why is that red? Maybe just because they have their station there or something? I don't know. I'm not sure. Go blow up that frontier outpost, though, because we don't want that there. We don't want that there. I want to either have control of that myself, or I just don't want them to have control of it. Whichever works. Either way.
Hostile fleet engaged.
Either way, we don't want them in control of it. Alright. Go ahead and send the, they've locked down that planet, but I need to lock down to keep them from sending these little cannon fodder up here. So, I need to send in the battleships. Send in the battleships.
Situation log updated.
It'll take them a little while to get there, of course, but once they do, things should go very poorly, very quickly, for these guys. Very poor, very quick. Okay, so I'm gonna warp into here, make sure they don't control anything there. Pretty sure the Holden system...
Research complete.
Actually, no, I don't think we've been there, so... probably do need to, okay, so there's the Ripper Cannons completed. Advanced railguns. Cool. Ah, so those carrier operations. Nice. So we can do fighter and bomber wings now. And then the armored torpedoes are actually really good too, but... let's go ahead... swap you back out for void craft. I kind of want the carrier stuff. Oh shit, I did not look to see which one you were in charge of. Oh, apparently it was that one, because it's no longer doing anything. Where's the person? There it is. And did I actually set you in charge? No, I didn't. There we go. Where you are now. Ooh.
Situation log updated.
Where did we just find that at? Sweet. Found that here. Okay. That's cool. That said, I do actually want to do that, so get up there and investigate.
Construction complete.
And then go ahead and jump into Unuk. I'm just going to basically clear out all of their ships, even though we don't necessarily need to wipe some of these guys out. We're going to pretty much do it anyway. Here comes our first Demolisher and our first Concordia class.
Hostile fleet engaged.
Look at them. Pretty neat. Pretty neat looking.
Situation log
updated.
What do you got here?
Stuff that's dead. That's what you got here.
Situation log
updated.
This
will blow up their
fleet engaged.
This blows up their stuff. So yeah. So what was I trying to make? Beta and Hishma. Beta and Hishma. Okay. I'm gonna go ahead and sweep through though and wipe out basically everything else that they own. Basically. We're just not gonna be We're not going to be friends to anyone. Oh no. What the fuck is that? Oh, that was the one that was going out there. I don't know. Oh, actually, he was not one of our researchers. Okay. Which does not, you know, does not mean that that was a good thing by any stretch of the imagination. But he's less... It's less bad that he is the guy that we have now. I mean, we don't really find anomalies anymore. I guess just take this. Because we simply don't find the ship these days.
Incoming transmission.
So. What's this? You want migration access? No. You're funny.
Situation log updated.
There's literally zero chance in hell I would allow for that. Are you bombarding my troops or something? It actually doesn't do anything if you bombard my troops, so I don't really know what you think you're doing, but... I can tell you what you're about to be doing. Dying.
Fleet engaged.
Very much about to be dying.
Hostile fleet engaged.
Hi, dude. You are so dead that you don't even know what you're dealing with.
Situation log updated. Situation log updated.
Vaporized. Oh, no, 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 no. Where does this idiot think he's going?
Hostile fleet engaged.
Okay, well, the spaceports doesn't have a serious effect, but it does, you know, hurt him and slow him down a little bit.
Situation log updated.
No! Damn it. No! I wanted to do the thing! You fuckers! And now I control way more planets than I can afford to control. Oh, my whole fucking fleet just disappeared. See, I don't like that it does that, that it just automatically ends the fighting. I was not prepared for the fighting to be over, guys. I was not at all prepared for the fighting to be over. Where do you think you're going? Okay, well, I have a lot of work to do now. I really wish that it wouldn't do this. I was not ready for that. I wanted to do the research there. I had things that I wanted to be doing. Can we attack these guys? can't tell you to attack them, unfortunately. Looks like I can't tell you to go and just attack them. Much as I would like to. Eh? But you'd already done that. That doesn't even make sense. Oh, whatever. Alright, so our fleet will come back to us eventually. We need to quickly look through these planets that we gained, of which there was quite a few. And we need to basically determine where precisely we want to, like, what precisely we want to do with all of them. Go ahead and go land at Erexo. We need to really quick, as I previously said, I have to really quick look through all these planets. We have to make sure that we're not, like, super seriously in immediate danger of having bad shit happen or whatever. For example, here, these people are starving. They won't be once that completes, but for the moment they are. I don't know why this is inactive. It's because you're unhappy? Are you not working because you're unhappy? Is that the problem? I don't really know what the problem is, but whatever the problem is, you're not doing what you should be doing, so going to kind of assume that that's the case. Oh, these are... Okay, never mind. Okay, so you're just engineering, I guess. And then you need to be a physics. Okay. That is a shitty little planet right there. Alright, so that was Bazanac. Here's this planet. You're not starving, at least. You need to do some upgrading, but you're not starving, so... You know, there's that. Apparently you're building? Oh, and when you're queued. I'm not entirely sure what all's going on here. You're growing, though, so you're fine. Okay, what about here? Oh, this place has a bunch of work that needs to be done on it. Because this is a planet that hasn't even been upgraded properly. Or at all, really. Hasn't been upgraded at all. Okay, what about here? Okay, I'll pay to just rip those out real quick. You guys are gonna need more food. Apparently you really wanted to go overboard with the science. This planet just has a ton of biolabs on it. Which just looks like it has a ton of just science labs in general on it. Totally didn't see that. Build a... hydroponics. Oh yeah, you're way short of the food that you need to build to live on this place, so go ahead and build another hydroponics. Here, I'll build a frontier clinic. right? Yeah. Frontier Clinic. And we mostly need energy credits, so I'm just going to turn this into... I'm just going to build a crapload of energy plants here in a second. Even though this planet has no energy production on it just yet, it will in a moment. I will have to maintain control of this at least for a little bit, but I don't need to control it for that long. I'll need to maintain control of most of these planets for just a little bit. None of them is really going to have to be for like a huge amount of time, but it needs to be long enough that I don't know if I need the hydroponics farm or not, but let's go ahead and build it. Again, I'm basically just going to build... primarily going to build... science and energy on this planet. Because it's a good-sized planet, and we could definitely use... just science and energy, really. We don't really need much else on it, so I'm not going to bother to build much else on it. Can only do so much here, I guess. Really. Only so much can be done here. I'm going to have to give these all of these over to non Imperial control, just because I can't. I don't have. I don't have the energy to be able to deal with all this. I just don't. So I'm going to have to give it over to non-Imperial Dominion, which I'm not super happy about. But most of these can be done without any real difficulty, but not super happy about it, but I don't really have a choice. It just has to be done, really. Okay, so go build research stations. They did not have... Either that, or I just blew everything up, which I know I did blow up most of the stuff, so that's probably the case. Oh, really? So it's not surveyed? I haven't seen that in a while. Seriously? What's going on here? The Erexo Pact left... what now? The Avabian Confederacy? I don't even know what the fuck that was. Whatever it was, they must not have been a part of it for very long, because they gone now. They gone now. Okay, so where's my one science ship that was... Apparently we have things for you to do. We have a system that has, or several systems actually, that have not been surveyed within our domain. Alright, seriously. Okay, let's go survey that for now. Unfortunately, this is not quite within my territory. So I might need to build a port there. One of the port control things here. Observation posts. Not observation posts, frontier posts. But can't do that just yet. Soon. Perhaps, but not just yet. I guess because the fleet never got... Could I not? That's annoying. I actually have a military outpost here, and I can't do anything about it. We haven't actually looked at these systems. I mean, obviously some of them we actually... The ones that we actually invaded... Obviously we destroyed anything like that, but we never got up there. Oh, they actually put a colony in the system. That's annoying, because I really want to research this. And now it appears that we can't. That is annoying. Tis annoying. Very annoying indeed. Oh well. You need to repair. You guys don't even need to repair, because you got repaired by the defense. By the your own capabilities. Alright, so I will, of course, have to spend some time. So you joined the Axis. You left the Federation. I don't know why this keeps telling me that you joined the Konding Axis. And apparently now the Aruxo have joined another Axis. Sanguine Axis. With the Jazigen? Now that is just an alliance, it's not a federation. Jazigen. These guys. Okay, so if we go to war with them again to finish wiping them out and take the rest of the territory, I'm not actually concerned about that, because those guys are like a fucking mile from us, so you're too far away to really be able to help them if push comes to shove or whatever. You're just too far away to be able to do anything about it. Really. I mean, you could try and do something about it, but it's not likely to do much for you. Okay, I need to give up these systems. I need to get on that. Need to get on that, because we are losing too much... Way too much of our stuff here. Alright, so the Aruxo sector is about to expand considerably. No, actually, I'm not going to give you that system. I'm only going to give you systems that are inhabited, because I don't want to give you... Oh, you're missing. Since I have to give you Furcad, but I don't want to give you Furcad. Okay, well. Okay, so that cuts that down, back down to where, closer to where it needs to be. Because then go ahead and just give you the holding system. I just don't want to give you stuff that you don't absolutely require. There we go. Problem mostly solved. As soon as you have five people, I can actually do something with you and I can get rid of this system. Because I don't really need it at this point. I've cleared out, started the clearing out there, and you just basically need... Actually, you know what I probably should do is I should just build a bunch of... Well, nah. I'll wait. Don't particularly want to wait, but I will wait. Yeah, so you are missing... You're missing a resource. Because one of the planets that I just took over must have a... Yeah, you got a Batharian power plant. Which I guess I'm just going to have to replace with... Well, maybe not. If not replace, I'm going to just have to rip it out, basically, and give it back to... I'm going to have to give you the one from Furcad. I think I just have... I have more Batharian stone resource things than I actually can use, I think, is the problem. I think that's the issue. So what I probably should do is I should just go into... I guess it actually has to be that specific system, doesn't it? And just turn this into a regular power plant. I think that's what I have to do. So let me do that really quick, because I just want to solve that problem. I don't want this to continue to be any sort of actual issue. So I'm just going to replace this with a regular power plant. Place that with a regular power plant, and then we can jump back in to the sector management and then give you right back to their control. And now we're making credits again. I lost quite a few in that short period of time when I was dicking around, but that's fine because it won't take very long to recover at the end of the day. Won't take us too long to get there, so it's alright. Okay, so I'm going to send you... Let's see, 4th and 2nd. Send you to merge with the 4th. 4th and 5th. Send you to merge with the 4th. That way they will all converge on the Dawnlight station, because it's the one... Oh, no, I'm actually wrong about that. The Alpha Centauri one is the one that's building. Oh, well, whatever. It's fine. Okay. Problem mostly solved. And... It won't be too long until we're able to start fixing this energy problem that I'm having. Again. We just have to gain a whole bunch more populations on this planet. In particular. Because this planet has a ton of food production. Or not food production, this planet has a ton of... energy things already built, and it's about to have a few more, and it's just going to be a massive power factory. So all this planet is going to be is just one massive power outpost. It's what it was originally intended to be. It's what it's going to remain. So that'll solve that issue. The strike is in orbit around the planet. Let's actually send them back to Alpha Centauri. We're at a negative balance because the fleet costs so much, but that's only a short-term problem. Oh no, our admiral died! No! Our badass admiral died. Oh. That makes me sad. That makes me very sad. Well, do we go with fire rate or ship upkeep? Both of them are very good. Yeah, we'll go with the fire rate. The main purpose really is to increase the capabilities of the ship, so... of the fleet, rather, so... Holy crap. The fleet is expensive to maintain without the admiral in charge. I'm sending them back to the Alpha Centauri post because... I didn't build it here. We're gonna have crew quarters here. I didn't actually build it here. I thought I had already built it, but that reduces the upkeep while that's in place. That's fine. He's fine. They'll get there quick enough. They'll get there soon enough, and I'm gonna have to end the episode here. We will, of course, be getting ourselves into position. I will have to solve my little energy problem at some point. One thing I will probably do... See, Hyderia is the sector that still primarily needs to grow. That's down here. Even though I have done some work to improve the area on my own, and might do more work to improve it on my own, for the time being, it's still hurting. It is still hurting right now. But there's really not a whole lot I can really safely do with it, though, is the problem. Really not a whole lot I can safely do with it. Oh well. The energy credit thing is not going to be a problem for forever. It's just a short-term issue. It's a serious short-term issue, mind you, but it is a short-term issue nevertheless. So it is one that I will be able to solve, given time. So, we'll see. We'll have to deal with that eventually. In the meantime, as previously said, thank you for... What's going on here? Oh, I can't land more troops. Can I get rid of all these defense armies? I don't need these defense armies. I don't know why you built them in the first place. I don't know why you built them in the first place, but I would like to land my offensive forces so they have a place that they can call home while they're just in chilling. Alright, so there's another faction. This is actually basically the old faction that we had already handled at one point and gotten rid of, and now they're back. But it shouldn't take us too long to deal with them. Help them to integrate. That'll solve the problem to a degree. It'll take a while, but it'll solve it eventually. The eventually part being the real issue, but it'll solve it eventually.
System survey complete.
Okay, folks. So, as I kind of had already said, thank you for watching. Of course, like and subscribe if you enjoy my stuff, and I will see you in the next episode. So
research
take it easy.
Complete.
Have a good day. And thank you for watching.